Nuclear weapons are a terrifying prospect, able to destroy a city in an instant. But do you really know the difference between a 10-kiloton atomic bomb or the 400-kiloton hydrogen bomb you see here? That is the object of this video. We will use a well-known location as ground zero in our journey to understanding. The Washington Monument in downtown Washington, D.C. For our first test, we will simulate a 100-ton detonation of a tactical nuclear demolition munition or Davy Crockett warhead. The monument is ground zero. A nuclear detonation equivalent to 100 tons of high explosives goes off at its base. Is the 15 PSI line. Within this ring, everything is gone. The second ring is the 5 PSI line. All but the strongest buildings will be destroyed. The third ring is the 2 PSI line. Homes will be destroyed. And the outer ring is 1 PSI, where homes would have severe damage. The monument itself would be shattered. Moderate structural damage to the American History Museum. And to the American Holocaust Museum, to the Bureau of Engraving and Printing. All of that from a device no bigger than a duffel bag that a teenager could carry. Next, we will simulate the blast of a 22-kiloton bomb, similar to the type used on Nagasaki. A plutonium implosion bomb equivalent to 22,000 tons of high explosive goes off at the base of the monument. This weapon was 220 times more powerful and caused much greater damage. There would be a crater roughly 300 feet across and 50 feet deep where the monument once stood. The White House would be destroyed. The Museum of Natural History would be in rubble, as would be the Vietnam Memorial, the Lincoln Memorial, and the Jefferson Memorial. The Capitol building would sustain serious damage, possibly collapsing the dome and destroying the priceless works of art therein. Across the river, every window in the Pentagon would be shattered. Next, we will simulate the explosion of a 400 kiloton RDS-6 thermonuclear weapon. This weapon has 18 times more power than the previous bomb. A thermonuclear blast equivalent to 800 million pounds of high explosives goes off at the base of the monument for an instant, heating the air to 100 million degrees. Utter devastation from the Capitol to the Lincoln Memorial. Everything is gone. Where the monument once stood is a hole, 1/2 mile across and several hundred feet deep. The George Washington Medical Center would be gone. The Pentagon's above ground portion would be in ruins. Every plane at Ronald Reagan Airport would be destroyed. Every tree in Arlington National Cemetery would be blown down. and JFK's eternal flame extinguished, and structural damage to homes in Alexandria, Virginia, 5 miles away. Next, the RDS-37 1.6 megaton hydrogen bomb. This weapon is 4 times more powerful than the 400 kiloton RDS-6 bomb we just simulated. Again, the monument is ground zero, where we unleash the power of the stars and sun on Earth. At ground zero would be a crater over 3,500 feet across and over 500 feet deep. McMillan Park would be completely destroyed, as would the Washington Zoo, the Pentagon, Reagan International, and Anacostia Naval Station. There would be structural home damage in Bethesda and in Silver Spring. And finally, the Tsar Bomba, the 27-ton, 57-megaton monstrosity that Khrushchev had tested in 1961. It was 35 times more powerful than the RDS-27 that we just simulated. It is still the most powerful device constructed by mankind. The poor monument, about to be blown up by the equivalent of 114 billion pounds of high explosives, or the weight of almost 1,000 Nimitz-class aircraft carriers. Devastation on a scale never before seen. A crater over 2 miles across and over 1,000 feet deep would lie where the monument stood. Washington, D.C., Alexandria, and Arlington, Virginia. Gone? From Mason Neck Park to Silver Spring to Fort Washington, nearly completely destroyed. Houses would have severe structural damage from Quantico to the suburbs of Baltimore. I hope you found my video entertaining. I do so love making them. Tell all your YouTube friends to give my videos a look-see. I have some pretty rare footage in my archives. You never know what you'll see next.